Hello students, in this today's lecture we are going to discuss about the third colligative property, that is called depression in the freezing point. Before going to depression in the freezing point, first of all the phase diagram of water. If you draw a graph between the vapor pressure versus temperature, that means the vapor pressure taken on the y-axis and the temperature is taken on the x-axis. Okay, now this diagram is called phase diagram of water. Now the point O, this is the triple point where the solid, liquid and gas state, all these three physical states are simultaneously exist at this point, and corresponding pressure 4.58 bar, triple point pressure, and corresponding temperature 0.01 degree Celsius triple point temperature. Are you getting my point? Now one by one, first of all O2A, this is a exponential curve. As the temperature increases, the vapor pressure also increases. The exponential curve along the OA, which is corresponding to the liquid and gas equilibrium. So this is the OA curve corresponding to OA graph corresponding to liquid and vapor equilibrium. Yes or no? Now come to the graph OB. The graph OB is corresponding to solid and liquid equilibrium. That means along the OB, both solid and liquid simultaneously exist in dynamic equilibrium. And the curve OC, which is corresponding to along the curve OC, both solid as well as gas simultaneously exist. Gas in the sense here vapor. Yes or no? Now you see, as the temperature increases, so the physical state of a substance keeping on changes from solid to liquid and liquid to vapor, that means the gas state. We know at high temperature ideal gas behavior. That's why almost if you see, as the temperature increases you will get the ideal gas behavior. That's why at high temperature you will get the gaseous substance. Are you getting my point? Now at low temperature, if you decrease the temperature, at low temperature you see the OB curve, which is slightly bending towards the y-axis. That means temperature will be lower. As the temperature will be lower, basically the solid state of water will be exist, that is the ice form. Are you getting my point? Now here, At one atmospheric pressure, the corresponding temperature is called boiling temperature. Yes, are you getting my point? What is the normal boiling point? It is the temperature at where the vapor pressure of a liquid equal to the surrounding pressure, that is called atmospheric pressure. Are you getting my point? Now, here at one atmospheric pressure, here this is the freezing point corresponding temperature. This is the temperature corresponding to the freezing point. That means here before this temperature you will get completely solid state. After crossing this temperature you will get the liquid state. But along the curve, that will be the along the path OB, you will get both solid and liquid equilibrium. Are you getting my point? Along the OC, you will get both solid as well as gaseous state. Both are exist in the dynamic equilibrium. OC left side only you will get, on the left hand only you will get what? Liquid here. Only you will get here gaseous state. Are you getting my point? Here, just wait. Now here, this will be the liquid, this will be the solid phase, and this will be the gaseous phase. Okay, now all these three physical states are simultaneously exist at the point O. This is known as a triple point. The pressure corresponding to triple point pressure 4.58 bar, and corresponding temperature is called triple point temperature. Yes or no? Now here, colligative properties which are directly proportional to number of moles of solute particles. As the number of solute particles increases, the colligative properties increases. This is very important. Now, boiling point. Boiling point directly proportional to concentration of the solute, that is the molality of the solute. Because as the number of solute particles increases, do you know, as the number of solute particles increases, that is the vapor pressure decreases. Vapor pressure decreases. In order to equal the vapor pressure to the surrounding pressure, we have to increase the temperature. That's why the boiling point of a solution increases as the number of solute particles increases. As the boiling point increases, this phenomena is known as an elevation in the boiling point. That means the elevation in the boiling point is a colligative property. So colligative property should be directly proportional to number of solute particles. Okay, now depression in the freezing point, this is to be discussed here. It is also directly proportional to number of solute particles. Okay, now vapor pressure. When the vapor pressure decreases with increasing of solute particles, vapor pressure decreases means lowering of vapor pressure, what happens? Increases. LVP. What is the delta P? Delta P, nothing but the P naught minus PS, which is also known as a lowering of vapor pressure, LVP. Okay, so it is also directly proportional to solute particles. Okay, now RLVP, that is the relative lowering of vapor pressure of a dilute solution. What is the formula of a RLVP? That will be delta P upon P naught. Delta P nothing but P naught minus PS divided by P naught. Okay, it is also directly proportional because RLVP is a colligative property. Okay, and one more colligative property is a osmotic pressure. What is the OP? Osmotic pressure. So in the next class we will discuss what is osmotic pressure. Okay, now depression in the freezing point. Already it is repeated here, depression in the freezing point is also directly proportional to number of solute particles. Now what about the freezing point and vapor pressure? They both are inversely proportional to number of solute particles. As the number of solute particles increases, vapor pressure decreases. As the number of solute particles increases, freezing point decreases. Are you getting my point? That means solute particles increases, freezing point decreases, and vapor pressure also decreases. When the freezing point decreases, lowering of freezing point, depression in the freezing point increases. When the vapor pressure decreases, that is the lowering of vapor pressure increases. Yes or no? Now, here in this today's lecture, the important topic is the depression in the freezing point. This is a third colligative property. First colligative property RLVP, second colligative property elevation in the boiling point, and the third colligative property is called depression in the freezing point. Okay, now the freezing point of a liquid, it is the temperature at where it begins to freeze. What is the definition of a freezing point? It is the temperature at which it freezes. It means liquid freezes. And the liquid gets separated out in the form of a crystalline solid. And the solid liquid both are exist in the dynamic equilibrium. Okay, that means the temperature at where the solid and liquid form of the liquid are coexist in the dynamic equilibrium. Let's suppose we have the water and ice. We know ice and water both are exist in the dynamic equilibrium at 0 degree Celsius, nothing but the 273 Kelvin, and the obviously the atmospheric pressure. If pressure is not mentioned, we should consider atmospheric pressure. So this temperature is called melting point of ice with respect to the solid, and freezing point of water, that is the with respect to the liquid. Okay, at the freezing point, the vapor pressure of a solid is equal to the vapor pressure of the liquid. This is very important. At freezing point, vapor pressure of a solid will be equal to vapor pressure of liquid. Vapor pressure of a solid will be equal to vapor pressure of a liquid. When a dilute solution is cooled to freezing point, when a dilute solution is cooling to its freezing point, then what happens? The solvent which is undergoing freezing should be crystallized in the pure form, and it is first separated out. Suppose if the solvent is water, in case of a water, what happens? Ice becomes separated from the solvent water. That means it is the temperature at where the solid form of a liquid begins to get separate, okay, in the form of a solid. The vapor pressure of a liquid decreases when a non-volatile solute is dissolved in a given volatile solvent. Already we know As the number of solute particles increases in a given solution, the solute is a non-volatile. Being a non-volatile nature, number of escaping molecules per unit area on the surface of a liquid, that is the solution, decreases. Thereby, vapor pressure decreases. This phenomena is known as a lowering of vapor pressure. Already we know. Okay. So due to which, the solid and liquid equilibrium will exist only at the temperature lower than the freezing point of the pure solvent. That means when a non-volatile solute is added, obviously the vapor pressure decreases. When the vapor pressure decreases, the freezing point of the solvent is also decreases. This is the called lowering of depression in the freezing point. Are you getting my point? This freezing point will be lower than that of whom? Pure solvent. Because in pure solvent, there will be no any solute. To the pure solvent, if a non-volatile solute is added, its vapor pressure decreases. That means at low temperature only, the solvent get freezes. Are you getting my point? In other words, for a solid to have the same vapor pressure as that of the solution, okay, for the freezing point, should be what happens? Lower, should be decreased. Then only the vapor pressure of a solid and liquid will be what? Equal. Okay, the freezing point of a pure solvent, let's suppose TF naught, and the freezing point of a solution is TFS. F stands for freezing and O stands for solvent and S stands for solution. Now the definition of a depression in the freezing point, it is a decrease in the freezing point. It is a decrease in the freezing point observed when a non-volatile solute is added to a pure solvent. When a non-volatile solute is added to a pure solvent, its vapor pressure, what happens? Decreases. When the vapor pressure decreases, freezing point also decreases. This is known as a depression in the freezing point. This is known as what? Depression in the freezing point. In other words, it is also known as the difference in the freezing point of a solvent and a solution. Do you know? Here, the freezing point of a solvent is more than that of the freezing point of a solution. Freezing point of a solution. This is very, very important. So due to which the freezing point of a solution, what happens? Decreases. So the difference in the freezing point of a pure solvent minus solution freezing point is called depression in the freezing point, delta TF. Yes or no? Now, we know the lowering of vapor pressure directly proportional to molality. Okay? The lowering of vapor pressure directly proportional to molality. And one more important thing, so the depression in the freezing point directly proportional to lowering of vapor pressure. Yes or no? The depression in the freezing point will be directly proportional to lowering of vapor pressure. But the lowering of vapor pressure directly proportional to molality. So indirectly, the depression in the freezing point is also directly proportional to whom? Molality. That means delta TF is directly proportional to concentration of the solution. Okay, which type of concentration? Molality. That means finally we can conclude that depression in the freezing point is directly proportional to molality of the solution. So experimentally it was observed that the boiling point, depression in the boiling point, this is what? Depression in the freezing point is directly proportional to the molality of the solution. So that's why what I am writing here, delta TF is directly proportional to molality. By removing the proportionality constant, I am writing a constant known as a proportionality constant KF, which is known as a molal depression constant. In the last class, I explained molal elevation constant, that is the KB. Similarly, here molal depression constant, it is also known as a cryoscopic constant. Now, how to find the molality? We know number of moles of a solute divided by weight of the solvent in kilograms is known as what? Molality of the solution. Okay. Now, in this diagram, if you see, pure solvent I am taking and solution I am taking. We know the pure solvent has always more vapor pressure than the solution. That's why the pure solvent vapor pressure temperature curve will be upper side and the solution vapor curve will be on the lower side. Okay. Now you see, when we are moving from right to left, that means we are lowering the temperature. When the temperature is lowering, that means A to B, this is a pure solvent. From the point B onwards, the solvent undergo freezing. From the point B onwards, solvent undergoing what? Freezing. That means the point B corresponding to the freezing point of the pure solvent. Point B, temperature corresponding to freezing point of the pure solvent. To the pure solvent, let's suppose when a non-volatile solute is added to get a solution. Again, if you are decreasing the temperature at a particular temperature, that means the C at a point C, from the point C onwards, what happens? The freezing of solvent occurs from the solution. Are you getting my point? That means from the point B, the solvent separate in the form of solid from the pure solvent. But whereas from the point C onwards, the solvent gets separated from the solution in the form of a solid in the solution. That means from B to C, if you see carefully, what about the freezing point? Freezing point decreases. Freezing point decreases. This phenomena is called lowering. This phenomena is known as a depression in the freezing point. So the difference between these two freezing points is called delta TF. Is known as what? Delta TF. Yes or no? Let's suppose if the solute undergoing ionization, then the Vanta factor iota greater than 1, otherwise association, the iota value less than 1. In that case, what is the final formula we have to remember? Delta TF is equal to Vanta factor multiplied by the KF, that is the molal depression constant, multiplied by the molality. Here we are not considering the iota Vanta factor because we are treating Vanta factor as a unity. Are you getting my point? But in the question, if the iota value it is given, otherwise some ionic compounds are given, then we have to consider the Vanta factor iota. Okay. Now what is the definition of a KF, which is known as a molal depression constant or cryoscopic constant? So in the last class, what is the definition of a molal elevation constant? It is the increase in the boiling point observed for the 1 molal solution. In the similar manner, it is the decrease in the freezing point. It is the decrease in the freezing point corresponding to the 1 molal solution. Otherwise, it is a decrease in the freezing point corresponding to the when 1 mole of a non-volatile solute is added to the 1 kg weight of the solvent. 1 kg weight of a solvent. Are you getting my point? Now, what is the delta TB? Sorry, delta TF is equal to iota. Okay, at present I am taking the iota value as a unity. Iota value as a unity. Delta TF is equal to KF multiplied by molality. Okay. Now from here, what's the KF value? KF is equal to delta TF divided by molality. Okay. What is the molality I am taking here? Unity. So that's why the KF value nothing but the delta TF value. Are you getting my point? What are the units for the delta TF depression, the freezing point? That is the degree Celsius or Kelvin. Okay. So SI unit I am taking the Kelvin. What is the unit for Kelvin? What is the unit for molality? Nothing but moles per kilogram. So overall you will get Kelvin into kg per mole. What is the unit for KF? Kelvin kg per mole. Now, how to find the KF value? How to find the KF value? To find the KF value, KF is equal to R TF square whole divided by 1000 into LF, latent heat of fusion. R stands for the gas constant and TF stands for the freezing point of the pure solvent, divided by 1000 into latent heat of fusion. What is the meaning of a latent heat of fusion? It is the amount of heat energy required to convert the 1 gram of a solid into a liquid at a constant temperature and pressure. Okay. Now in case of a enthalpy of fusion, R TF square whole divided by 1000 into, instead of latent heat of fusion, if the enthalpy of fusion is given in the question, divided by, we have to write the molar mass of the solvent. So the molar mass of a solvent will be goes to the numerator. So it will be goes to the numerator. Are you getting my point? Now what is the R value? R value is a gas constant. So what is the R value? R value generally we are considering as a 2 calorie per mole per Kelvin. Otherwise R value 8.314 joule per mole and per Kelvin. Yes or no? Now the important conclusion here, the molar depression constant value, it is a characteristic constant for the solvent. For a particular solvent, there is a only one fixed molal depression constant. It is only changes by changing of the solvent, and it do not change by changing of the solute. That means the KF value depend on the nature of solvent only, and it is independent on the nature of the solute. Yes or no? Now there are different types of solvents are there. Let's suppose water is there, okay, ethanol, cyclohexane, benzene is there, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, carbon disulfide, diethyl ether, and acetic acid. And the freezing point of water we know 273 Kelvin, and corresponding KF value given as a 1.86. So this value is very very important, because in most of the question the solvent will be water. So what is the KF regarding the solvent water? This value is very important. Okay, the KF value, it is a experimental value. So that's why most of the questions the KF value given. Otherwise, with the other information, we have to calculate the KF for solvent. Now, what is the KF for water? This is very important. For water, what will be the KF value, which is equal to 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. So this is a very 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 important value regarding the solvent to water only. Yes or no? Solvent to water. Okay, now what are the importance application of the freezing point? Now here, in anti-freezing substances like ethyl alcohol, ethylene glycol, these are added to the water in the car radiator. Why? Because when the surrounding temperature downfalls, whatever the water in the radiator of a car freezes, due to which the radiator will break down. So to avoid such things, what we have to do, we have to add some ethyl alcohol, glycerol to the water. So these compounds act as anti-freezing substances, and they avoid the freezing of water. Are you getting my point? That's why these substances are known as what? Anti-freezing substances. What is the formula of ethyl alcohol? C2H5OH. What is the ethylene glycol? CH2OH. CH2OH. What is the CH2OH? CH2OH. This is called ethylene glycol. Ethylene glycol is a dihydroxy alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is a monohydroxy alcohol. Okay, the molecular formula is very important. And second application here, in the melting of ice on the roads in the winter, okay, in hill stations, especially when the surrounding temperature downfalls, what about the where ice snows heavily, due to which the roads are completely blocked with the heavy snow. So in that situation, what happens? The salt like sodium chloride, calcium chloride are scattered, okay, spread on the surface of the roads, due to which ice slowly, what happens, melts. Because when NaCl and ice both are combining, the freezing point will be lowering to minus 21 degrees Celsius. And calcium chloride, ice, when these two put together, the freezing point lowering to minus 55 degrees Celsius. That means as long as the temperature of the surrounding is above these temperatures, that means minus 21 degrees centigrade above temperature, that will be minus 20, minus 15, minus 10. Up to that temperature, what happens? Ice slowly melted. When the temperature downfall to minus 21 or minus 55, that is the surrounding temperature, then again water freezes to give ice. Are you getting my point? As long as the temperature of the surroundings is above these temperature, the ice slowly melted. Are you getting my point? Now, there are some questions regarding the depression in the freezing point. The first question, that is the 87th question, latent heat of fusion of ice 80 calorie per gram and freezing point of water 0 degree Celsius, find the molal depression constant for water. Now, what is the latent heat of fusion of ice is given here? 80 calorie per gram. And what is the freezing point of solvent water? 0 degrees, nothing but 273 Kelvin. Okay. Now here R value I am taking 2 calorie per mole per Kelvin. Okay. What is the R value? What is the KF value? R TF square whole divided by 1000 into latent heat of fusion. 1000 multiplied by latent heat of fusion. Yes or no? Now the Kf value equal to R value 2. What is the freezing point of water? That will be 273 Kelvin. So 273 whole square. Whole divided by 1000 multiplied by the latent heat of fusion of ice will be 80 calorie per gram. Okay. After complete simplification, you will get 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Yes or no? So this is a standard value regarding the solvent water, because already I told you we have to remember the Kf regarding the solvent water. Okay, because in most of the questions the solvent will be the water. Okay, now question number 88. In this question number 88, 6.8 grams of a non-electrolyte is added to 100 grams of water to form the freezes at minus 0.93 degrees Celsius. What is the freezing point of water? First of all, 0 degrees Celsius. And what is the freezing point of the solution is given? Minus 0.93 degrees Celsius. What will be the delta Tf? That will be freezing point of solvent minus of freezing point of solution. 0 minus of minus, that will be plus 0.93 degrees Celsius, otherwise Kelvin, because the temperature difference you can take in degrees Celsius or Kelvin. Okay, the weight of solvent is 100 grams, and the Kf for water is also, we know that will be 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, now find the molecular weight of the non-electrolyte. Here the iota value, that will be non-electrolyte, that's why we are using the iota value 1. So directly, what is the formula? Delta Tf is equal to iota into Kf into molality. Okay, now from here delta Tf value, that is the 0.93, is equal to iota value 1, and the Kf value will be 1.86. molality, weight of the solute divided by molecular weight of a solute, that is to be calculated, into 1000 by what is the weight of a solvent, that will be the 100 grams. That will be the 100 grams. Overall, the molar mass of a non-volatile solute, which is equal to 136 gram per mole. 136, that is the D option. Yes or no? Now, question number 89. After adding a non-volatile solute, freezing point of water decreases to minus 0.186. that means directly we can write the depression in the freezing point, 0.186 degrees Celsius or Kelvin. Then the delta Tb value. So what is the delta Tb value? Remember, depression in the freezing point is given, but asking elevation in the boiling point. Do you know delta Tb is equal to iota into Kb into molality? Yes or no? Now for the same solute and same solvent, delta Tf is equal to iota into Kf into molality. Same solute, same solvent. So the ratio, if you see, 1/2, delta Tb upon delta Tf, iota gets cancelled, Kf molality gets cancelled, so finally we will get Kb upon Kf. Okay, now delta Tb to be calculated, delta Tf value given in the question 0.186, Kb value given 0.521, and Kf value given 1.86. are you getting my point? So the final answer will be here. Delta Tb will be equal to 0.0521 degree Celsius or Kelvin. Degree Celsius or Kelvin, 0.0521, that will be the B option. Okay. Now, here, this is the delta Tb, which is equal to delta Tb, which is equal to 0.0521. Okay, now come to the next question, that is the question number 90. What is the amount of ethylene glycol is added to the 5 kilograms of water to just to prevent the freezing of water at minus 0.3 degrees Celsius? That means what is the lowering of, what is the depression in the freezing point? 0.3 degrees Celsius or Kelvin. Okay, and what is the Kf for solvent is given here? 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Do you know what is the molar mass of a ethylene glycol? That is ethylene glycol. ethylene glycol molecular formula, just now I told you CH2OH. Yes or no? What is the molecular weight of the solute? That is the ethylene glycol, 62. Okay, so directly we are using the formula delta TF is equal to iota into KF into molality. Here the solute will be the covalent compound, so that's why we are considering the iota for ethylene glycol as a unity. Okay, delta TF value 0.3 is equal to iota value 1, KF value 1.86, molality weight of the solute to be calculated, molecular weight of a solute is 62 into 1 by weight of a solvent will be 5 kgs. Okay, from here the weight of a solute will be equal to 50 grams. That means if we add the 50 grams of ethylene glycol, how many grams of ethylene glycol? 50 grams. When we add ethylene glycol 50 grams to the 5 kg water, we can stop the freezing of water at 0.3 degrees Celsius. Yes or no? Now, the question number, that will be the 91, the amount of ice that will be separated out on cooling the solution containing the 50 grams of ethylene glycol in the 200 grams of water at minus 9.3 degrees Celsius. Okay, the K for water is given. Similarly, here also, what is the delta TF here? 9.3 degrees Celsius. What is the K for solvent water? That will be 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, now what is the amount of what is the amount of ice to be get separated? Now, first of all, delta TF is equal to iota multiplied by KF multiplied by molality. Yes or no? Now, the depression in the freezing point 9.3 is equal to iota value here also 1 into KF value 1.86. Now, molality, what is the weight of a solute? The weight of a solute, that is the ethylene glycol, 50 gram. Divided by what is the molar mass of a ethylene glycol, 62, because in the previous question ethylene glycol molar mass will be 62. Okay, are you getting my point? Into 1000 by weight of a solvent will be how many grams given here? That is actually 200 grams of solvent is given, but ethylene glycol is added to the water to avoid the freezing of water. So now I am trying to calculating the weight of solvent. Okay, now here the weight of solvent will be equal to the weight of solvent, that is the water, liquid water, will be equal to 161.29 grams. That means at minus 9.3 degrees Celsius, out of the 200 grams of solvent water, still 161.29 grams of solvent will be present in the liquid form. So total weight of water is equal to 200 grams. Okay, now the amount of water gets separated in the form of ice, will be equal to total 200 grams. Now still there is a 161.29 grams of solvent water will be present. That means the remaining amount will be 38.71 grams, which is the amount of the solid water, that is called ice. So answer 38.71 grams, that will be the D option. Okay, important question. Now the question number 92, 0.1 molal, otherwise 0.1 molality aqueous solution of complex COCl3. Complex formula is COCl3XNH3, shows a depression in the freezing point of 0.55 degrees Celsius. If the K for water is 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole, assume 100% dissociation of a complex and coordination number of the complex is 6. The coordination number of complex is what? 6 here. Then the formula of the complex. First of all, try to calculate the iota van't Hoff factor. Okay. Now, first of all, delta TF is equal to iota multiplied by KF multiplied by molality. Yes or no? What is the depression in the freezing point is given here? 0.558 degrees Celsius. Iota. What is the KF for solvent water? 1.86. And what is the molality given here? 0.1. What is the molality given here? 0.1. From here, the iota value equal to 3. Okay. Here, alpha value given 100%. Okay. Now, here, iota is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. Yes or no? If the alpha value 100%, then the iota value equal to number of ions produced. Number of ions produced and iota Vanta factor both are equal. Are you getting my point? That means overall we have 3 ions in the solution. How many ions in the solution? Because iota value 3. So finally, number of ions produced. Number of ions produced will be iota, which is equal to 3. So first of all, we can check each and every option. You see, first option, this is a complex. When the complex is dissolved in water, how this complex will dissociate it? Do you know this is a square bracket? The entire square bracket species will be single species. Okay. Now, how many chloride ions are outside the square bracket? 3. So they are completely dissociated. So total 1 cation and 3 anion. So iota value or number of particles 1 plus 3, that will be equal to 4. But our iota value equal to 3. So this is not the first option. Now come to second one. When the second one also dissociated in water, do you know the complete square bracket is treated as a one species, one particle? Okay. And the one chloride ion is there, that will be present outside. So total 1 plus 1, 2 particles are present. So iota value 2. Come to third option. So the total square bracket should be kept only in one species, as a one species. CO, NH3 taken 5, Cl. And outside 2 chlorines are there. When they get ionizes as a 2 chloride ions, total 2 anions and 1 cation. So overall the iota value here will be 3. Are you getting my point? Now here the iota value already we calculated, that is also 3. That means the C option will be the correct option. Yes or no? Now the fourth option, there will be no any other ion, there is no any counter ion, the ion which is outside the square bracket. That means here the complex do not undergo any ionization. The complex species taken as a only one species. That means here the iota value is a unity. Iota value is a unity. So finally, we can conclude which option is the correct option. Option number C. Yes or no? Now, we will detailly discuss in the topic of, in the chapter of coordination compounds. Okay, what are coordination compounds? How to determine their formula, etc. Okay. Now, question number 93. 75.2 grams of a phenol is dissolved in the 1 kg weight of a solvent if the depression in the freezing point will be 7 Kelvin. Depression in the freezing point will be 7 Kelvin. Okay. The degree of association of the phenol that will dimerize. That means here phenol, C6H5OH. Okay. 2 moles of a phenol I am taking. Here what happens? Phenol undergo dimerization. Phenol undergo what? Dimerization. The question is dimerization. The question is percentage of degree of association. Okay. Do you know the molecular weight of a phenol, which is equal to 94. Okay. Now first of all, I have to find the iota. Delta TF is equal to iota KF into molality. Yes or no? Now here 7 Kelvin. Iota value to be calculated, KF value solvent 14, and what is the molality? Given weight of solute 75.2, molar mass of a solute will be 94 into the solvent weight is given 1 kilogram. Okay, from here, shall I find the iota value? The iota value will be 0.625. What is the iota value? 0.625. Okay. Now what is the alpha value? Alpha is equal to 1 minus iota upon 1 minus 1 by n. We know the degree of association. What is the iota value? Okay. Now alpha is equal to 1 minus I by 1 minus 1 by 1 minus 1 by n. So alpha value equal to 1 minus iota value 0.625 by 1 minus 1 by n value here 2. Okay. 0.625. 75. Otherwise, in terms of percentage, 75% association occurs. How much of percentage? 75% association occurs. Okay. Now, the question number 94. 0.001 molar solution of a complex PC represented as a PtNH3 taken for Cl4 in water. That means this is a complex given PtCl4NH4. Okay. Now here, the depression in the freezing point will be 0.0054 degrees Celsius. Kf for water 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Assume 100% ionization. Again the complex formula. So first of all, what is the given data here? According to given data, depression in the freezing point will be 0.0054 degrees Celsius. And Kf for solvent will be 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. Okay. Now what about the alpha given as a 100%? That means iota value indirectly number of ions produced. Yes or no? Number of ions produced will be equal to iota. Yes or no? Let's suppose here chlorine is a ionizable. Ammonia is a non-ionizable because ammonia is a neutral molecule. So what I am trying to write here, let's suppose platinum, ammonia, how many molecules are there? 4 molecules. But the chlorine, how many atoms are there? 4. Out of 4, let's suppose X chlorine atoms are present in the square bracket. But means in the square bracket, whatever the species present, that species do not undergo ionization. Let's suppose out of the square bracket, out of the total 4 chlorine, X chlorine will be inside and the remaining chlorines will be 4 minus X outside. Yes or no? Let's suppose if this complex will be dissociated in the water. Then how it dissociated? Entire square bracket will be one species. Yes or no? That means Pt, NH3, taken 4 and ClX. Plus how many chlorines outside the square bracket? 4 minus X, Cl minus. So this is the 4 minus X plus charge. So because positive charge, negative charge should be counterbalanced. Okay. Now total ions, how many produce here? Total number of ions, how many produces here? That will be equal to 1 square bracket plus 4 minus X. Total 5 minus X. Are you getting my point? The total number of ions, nothing but here iota. So first of all, try to calculate the iota. How to calculate the Vanta factor? Delta Tf is equal to I into Kf into molality. Yes or no? No. What is the delta Tf value? 0.0054 degrees Celsius. Iota value to be calculated. Kf for solvent water 1.86. And the molality value given as a 0.001. Okay. From here, the iota value will be 2.9. Approximately the next integer I am taking the iota value 3, but actually the iota value how much? 5 minus x. So 5 minus x iota value, but actually iota value we got here 3. So iota value we got 3. Are you getting my point? So 5 minus x will be equal to 3. So x will be equal to how much? 2. X will be equal to how much? 2. That means the complex PtNH3 taken 4, the chlorine, out of the 4 chlorine atoms, 2 chlorine atoms are present inside the square bracket and the remaining 2 chlorines are present in the outside the square bracket. When it is dissociated, it will produce Pt, NH3 taken 4, Cl2 dipositive plus 2 Cl minus. So this is the ionization equation and this is the complex formula. What is the complex formula? Pt, NH3 taken 4, Cl2, whole taken Cl2, okay. Now, question number 95. Depression of the freezing point of 0.01 molar aqueous acetic acid solution will be 0.02046 degrees Celsius and 1 molar urea aqueous solution freezes at -1.86. Assuming the molality equal to molarity, find the pH of the acetic acid solution. Now you see, the solvent aqueous, that is the solvent water, so the Kf value not given, but obviously we know 1.86, still we have to find the Kf value accurately, because in the question the Kf value not given, but one information is given here: 1 molar urea solution freezes. That means delta Tf is equal to iota into Kf into molality. Okay, what is the depression in the freezing point? 1.86. iota to be calculated. Iota value for urea, just wait, iota value for urea is unity, and Kf value to be calculated, and the molality will be 1 molal. So from here, what is the Kf value? 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. We know the Kf value of solvent water is 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. For such purpose only, the 1 mole urea solution freezes at minus 1.86 degrees Celsius is given. Okay, now here what is the stic acid concentration? 0.01 molal. Remember, molality assumed to be same. Okay, 0.01 molal acetic acid is given, and what is the depression in the freezing point of acetic acid is given? 0.02046 degrees Celsius. From here, I have to find the iota, that is called Van 't Hoff factor. Okay, now what is the depression here? 0.02046, which is equal to iota to be calculated. Kf value from the expression 1.86, and what is the molality? 0.01. okay, from here the iota value equal to 1.1. iota value equal to how much? 1.1. okay, now from iota value, can I find the degree of ionization alpha? Yes, iota is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. Yes or no? What is the n value? Do you know acetic acid dissociated as a acetate ion and H plus ion? So number of particles produced will be 2. So iota value will be 1.1. okay, from here what is the alpha value? That will be the 0.1. alpha value how much? 0.1. okay, now how acetic acid dissociated? We know in ionic equilibrium a weak electrolyte, how it dissociated acetic acid? As a acetate ion, CH3COO- and H plus. Okay, now initial concentration C, so there will be no any initial concentration at a equilibrium. Suppose alpha moles dissociated from 1 moles, from the C mole C alpha dissociated, the remaining mole C minus C alpha, and here C alpha and C alpha moles of acetate ion and H plus are formed. So from here, what is the H plus ion concentration? That will be C into alpha. So the H plus ion concentration, what is the molality? 10 to the power minus 2. And what is the alpha value here? 0.1. So overall 10 to the power minus 3. Are you getting my point? Now what is the pH formula? Negative logarithm to the base 10 of H plus ion concentration. So pH is equal to minus log of 10 to the power minus 3. So pH will be equal to 3 into log 10. We know log 10 value 1. So 3 into 1, that will be the answer 3. Okay, now the question number 96. The question number 96. 1000 grams of water having 0.1 mole urea, and it freezes to minus 0.2 degrees Celsius. And now it is freezes up to minus 2 degrees Celsius. Then how much of amount of water get solidified in the form of ice? Okay, first of all, what is the formula here? Delta Tf is equal to iota into Kf into molality. First of all, what is the depression in the freezing point initially? 0.2. iota value as it is I am writing, Kf value also as it is I am writing, and what is the molality? Number of moles by weight of a solvent in 1 kg. So already 1000 grams means 1 kg. Are you getting my point? Now this will be the, otherwise 1000 upon 1000. Okay, this will be the equation number 1. And the next depression in the freezing point will be 2 degrees. Okay, Kf into, now here 0.1, concentration of solution will be same, 1000. Now what I am trying to do here, I am trying to calculating the weight of the solvent, because the first of all, the freezing point depression 0.2. Further decreasing of the freezing point, definitely some part of water become solidified as a ice. So that's why at minus 2 degrees Celsius, what I am trying to calculating here, weight of solvent. Okay, after solving equation 1 and 2, so 1/2 0.1 will be equal to weight of the solvent whole divided by 1000. That means the weight of solvent will be equal to 100 grams. That means still at minus 2 degrees Celsius, the water will be present in the liquid form as a 100 grams. So total weight of water is given 1000 grams. But still at minus 2 degrees Celsius, the 100 grams of water left. That means the amount of water get ice, the amount of water becomes ice will be total 1000 grams of water. Now 100 grams of water still present. That means the 900 grams of water get in the form of solid state ice. Yes or no? Question number 97. Which of the following aqua solution will have highest depression in the freezing point? Do you know depression in the freezing point? Iota into Kf into molality. Now generally I told you depression in the freezing point directly proportional to number of solute particles. Because in the given option you see molality will be remain same 0.1 molal. And the Kf solvent will be also same. So that's why that delta Df directly proportional to iota, that is the number of solute particles. Now urea, if you see, in urea, the number of solute particles, that is called iota, which is equal to 1. In case of sucrose, also iota value equal to 1. In case of aluminum chloride, 1 aluminum cation and 3 chloride, 1 plus 3 will be 4. But in case of K4FeCN taken 6 times, you see the square bracket, entire square bracket will be one species only. So 4 potassium ions and 1 ferrocyanide ion. 1 ferrocyanide ion. 4 plus 1 equal to total 5 particles. Number of particles increases. Depression in the freezing point also increases. Highest depression in the freezing point. Okay. Now the question number 98, that is the last question. The depression in the freezing point for 1 molal urea, 1 molal glucose and 1 molal NaCl. Here also, the depression in the freezing point will be equal to iota multiplied by Kf multiplied by molality. Do you know, here also Kf is remains constant and in each solution there is a molality 1 mole. So directly we can conclude that delta Tf is directly proportional to iota, that is the Vanta factor. Now urea has the Vanta factor 1 and glucose is also having the Van factor 1. NaCl, when it dissolves in water, it produces 2 particles. So 1:1:2 will be the ratio regarding the depression in the freezing point. 1:1:2, that is the option number C.